Hello, boys and girls. Today we are going to learn how to correctly print the lowercase plain line letters P and J. Both of these letters are consonants and they're both stopper sounds, which means that you cut the sound off very quickly when you make it. P stands for the sound p, like you hear in pop or pig. J stands for the sound j, like you hear at the beginning of the word jar or jump. Notice that both of these letters sort of go down at the bottom. They are our first plain line letters that will actually dip down under the grass line. So we actually might get to use our special worm line today when we write these letters. Now, if you do not have Foundation's printing paper at home, any plain handwriting paper with just the three lines will be fine. But you're not going to have this extra worm line at the bottom. So you just have to sort of imagine that it's there. Okay, most handwriting paper does not have this. This is called the worm line in Foundations. Okay, so if you don't have that, just know that you're going to stop somewhere a little bit below the bottom line on your handwriting paper at home. Okay, so our lowercase letter P is the one that we are going to begin with. To make the letter P, you will take your pencil, you will point to the plain line, you go down, the whole way down, under the bottom grass line, the whole way down to that worm line. Okay, so I'm going to show you one more time. You go down to the worm line, trace back up to the plain line, and curve all the way around to the grass line, just like that. Okay, so you really do not need to pick up your pencil at all between the worm line and then your curve here. Okay, I did it the first time just to show you where I stopped, but you can do this all in one movement with your pencil like this. Okay. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Let's try it again. This time I'm not going to pause at all. We point our pencil to the middle plain line. That's the dash line. Okay, so we point to the plain line. Go down to the worm line. Trace back up to the plain line and curve all the way around to the grass line. And that is the lowercase letter P, which stands for the sound P. Great. This time, we're going to write our letter P again, but I want you to make the sound with me. Now, P is a stopper sound. It's not stretchy, so we can't hold on to that sound the whole time we write the letter. No. It's a stopper, so we have to make it over and over again like this. Okay? You can get your magic finger or your arm ready to make the P with me. Okay, so I'm going to point my pencil to the middle plain line. And let's get our voices ready. Let's begin. Go. Excellent. And there you have the lowercase plain line letter P, which stands for the sound P, like P, pan, P. Say that with me. P, pan, P. Excellent. P, pan, P. Now, if you do not have the worm line at home, your letter P goes sort of under the ground. okay? Worms live under the ground. That's why it's the worm line. But under the ground, meaning that you go down below the grass line, about this far, and stop. Okay? So let's pretend like I have just lined paper like this at home. You would just sort of imagine that the worm line would be right about here. Okay, and you would start at the plain line on your regular paper. Go down below the bottom line, trace back up to the middle dotted line, and curve around to the bottom line. Okay, I'll show you one more time. You would point to the middle dotted line on your regular handwriting paper. Go down below the bottom line, trace back up to the middle line, curve around to the bottom again, and stop. Okay. Your next letter, and the last one for today's lesson, is the plain line letter J. Okay, so that's lowercase J, which stands for the sound J. Okay. So to make J, again, we start at the plain line, or if you're using regular handwriting paper, it's your middle dotted or dashed line. So we're going to point our pencil to the plain line, go all the way down under the ground to the worm line. You make a curve, and then you add a dot. Ooh, Mrs. Pendleton went a little bit too far below the worm line. But that's okay, it was my first time. Let's try it again. Point your pencil to the plain line. Go all the way down to the worm line, curve. Then you add the dot. Notice that only two of the lowercase letters that we wrote so far have this dot. The lowercase letter J, and also the letter we wrote in our last lesson, or maybe two lessons ago, the lowercase letter I. I also has that little dot. Okay? So, J stands for the sound J, like you hear at the beginning of jug or jump. Or even jar. Can you make the sound with me? J, j, j. Good. J is also a stopper sound, meaning we cannot stretch that sound out for a long time. We can't hold on to it when we write it either. So we are going to make the sound over and over again as we write our last letter, J. Okay? So let's try one more time. I'm going to point my pencil to the plain line. And get ready to say the sound. Ready, go. J, 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 j. And that is the letter J. So today you learned how to write the lowercase plain line letters P and J. Okay, we call them plain line letters because they begin with your pencil pointing to the middle plain line on our foundations paper. But they go the whole way down below our bottom grass line, the whole way down to this worm line. So again, if you do not have foundations handwriting paper at home and you have regular paper with like dotted or dashed lines like this without the pictures, that's okay. I'll show you quickly how you would write a letter J. We're just going to pretend or imagine. We're going to visualize that there's a line, a worm line there under the ground. Even though there's not, it's just a blank space. Okay, so we're going to stop somewhere about here to make our little curve. Okay, so if you have regular writing paper at home, you start at the middle line. You're going to go down below your bottom line and curve up a little bit. Then put a dot on top. Let's try it again. J, 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 j. Okay, and those are your lowercase letters. P, and J. As always, thanks for tuning in. I hope you learned something. Bye.